Well, despite the president's repeated efforts to get them out, American troops remain deployed in parts of Syria. If Washington has its way, they will be there until you are old, or even longer, forever. But it could be worse. 19 months ago, Washington was demanding that the U.S. government topple the Assad government completely. Must do it now. The justification for this was a supposed chemical weapons attack in the town of Douma. Now, no one in Washington had seen the attack. No American had seen it. Nobody in Congress could tell you what proof existed that the attack had actually taken place or that Assad's government was behind it rather than some other faction, and there were many, in the country's civil war. But it didn't matter that there was literally no evidence. Everybody in Washington began agitating for regime change war immediately. Immediately, and especially on the left. Bill Kristol and Max Boot and everyone on MSNBC and CNN, they were completely for it. This show was not for it. We didn't deny the attack happened. We just told people to be skeptical. You got to depose Assad immediately. Wait a second. How did it work when we deposed the last four Arab leaders? And wait a second. Didn't the Assad government, evil as it may be, protect all the Christians? Shut up, they said. You got to do it now. Well, fortunately, the president, President Trump, limited his response to another wave of missile strikes rather than sending U.S. troops in to topple yet another government in the region. But now it looks like even that response may have not been justified at all. So last spring, the official report of the Organization for the Prohibition of Chemical Weapons, which is the group that monitors chemical weapons globally, said the Douma attack was caused by two chlorine gas canisters that were dropped from an airplane. That would suggest the Assad government was behind the attack. Okay. But then last May, a leaked internal document showed that one of the OPCW's top analysts disagreed with that conclusion. He thought the canisters were placed by hand by someone on the ground, which would make it a completely different event. Now, this week, WikiLeaks has published an email from a member of the OPCW's fact-finding team. That email accuses the organization of altering investigators' original findings to make evidence of an attack look more conclusive than it actually was. Sound familiar? Yeah, we've seen this movie before, with tragic consequences. Yet another OPCW whistleblower has argued that on-the-ground evidence points against an attack happening at all. So in other words, America almost attacked a country and killed thousands, untold thousands of people over an attack that may never have happened in the first place, that powerful people may very well be lying about. And by the way, under a different president, and whatever you think of Trump, this is true. Under a different president, say Hillary Clinton, being advised by the Obama foreign policy team, Samantha Power, and a lot of people like Samantha Power, with long track records of unwise, indeed stupid decision making, under that administration, we probably would have invaded. We recently spoke all about this story because we think it's important with Jonathan Steele. He's a former chief foreign correspondent for The Guardian. Here's the conversation. I don't want to overstate this. A lot of us, well, not a lot, some of us, this show, had suspicions from the outset that there wasn't much evidence that this had actually happened. What do we now know?
Well, we now know from this whistleblower who prefers to call himself Alex, we know his real name, and we've got proof that he did work at the OPCW. He was an inspector, one of the team of about nine people who went to Damascus and to Douma to pick up samples on the ground and to talk to witnesses and check the whole thing out. Now, he took these samples, but the main point is that chlorine gas degrades rapidly in the air, so that coming in 2 weeks later, you wouldn't find anything. But what you would find is that the gas can contaminate or affect other chemicals in the natural environment,
yes,
so-called chlorinated organic chemicals. But the difficulty is that they exist anyway in the natural environment anyway, and in water and so on. And so the crucial thing is the levels. Were there more higher levels of chlorinated organic chemicals found after the alleged gas attack than there would have been in the normal environment? And when they got back to the Netherlands, to The Hague, where the OPCW has its headquarters, the samples were sent off to designated laboratories. Then there was a weird silence developed. Nobody told the inspectors what the results of the analysis was. And it was only by chance that the inspector found out that 3 weeks earlier the results had come in and they showed no difference at all. There were no higher levels of chlorinated organic chemicals in the areas where the alleged attack happened, where there's some suspicious cylinders had been found by opposition activists. And so there, it didn't seem possible that there could have been a gas attack because the levels were just the same as in the natural environment.
Well, I'm confused by 2 points. So first, we were told, and again, sternly lectured, that the U.S. government had absolute evidence that this gas attack took place, A. B, if OPCW knew that there wasn't actually evidence, why did it take a whistleblower to tell the rest of us?
Well, on the first point, I mean, they just rushed. It was rushed to judgment. The missile strikes, which included British and French missiles as well as the American ones, happened about 2 or 3 days after the alleged gas attack. When no inspectors had been on the ground, there was no evidence on the ground. So it was
liars.
Just fabricated, as it were, the reason to go in. It was a rush to judgment. But the second point is that there was no real reason why Assad would make an attack at this stage, because he was already capturing most of Douma and was about to capture the rest of it. He didn't need to go in for a chemical gas attack at that stage.
We've been lied to. We've been manipulated. We knew it at the time. Thanks so much for coming on tonight. I appreciate that. It's a fascinating story. It's an important story. I hope it gets picked up by others apart from just this show. Jonathan Steele, thank you.